with their guns and their boot stepping on me. I felt so numb within my limbs, my legs, my hands. It was so painful, so much. I cried than ever before I've ever done, not even the Alua. Up to now, whenever I remember that pain, it really gets back to me. It was very painful. My Lord, they took me for about 2 hours. Reached at the gate which I had. The gates opened so fast. And one of them asked, "Who is that?" One of the officers asked, "It is this dog, Zake." I had thought that maybe this is the person I would be asking for help from, because I asked him, "Please help me." He really didn't. And I heard a word in Lunyankole saying, "What?" And a word in Lunyankole, something like, but it meant that you're now just farting, but you'll soon defecate. Something like, was a nyampa and something like that. I was hearing something of that kind because I can listen to the language, though I cannot speak it. It was very disappointing because I had thought maybe I'd reached a police station where at least I'll be put in maybe a place with dignity and not inflicting more pain. These people within the compound, while still on handcuffs, after untying me, they really forced me that I should walk. Something which I could not do. I fell down. They stopped on my head with their boots. Beating started from their compound. They dragged me down stairs. The echoes I heard made me feel that now this is a very huge building. They put me down on the floor. They began caning me so much while on being handcuffed. Sincerely, I cannot count the number of strokes they gave to me. But it was adding more pain to the extent that I was not even now not feeling anything, since my hands were already numb and still handcuffed. I could not feel my limbs, the legs. That was the time they really telling me that I'm just a shitted dog. And they said that in Lunyankole still mazi, something like that. That you, Zake, you're always there with Honorable Chagulani, lying to yourself that I'm Uganda will ever become a president. But trust me, you should be aware from today that this country has its owners. And you people, you're not part of the owners of this country. It is Muzei. And they were referring to President Museveni. Those people, whenever I would say anything, it really added more pain on me. There is something I felt like a stick, like having things which were piercing on my chest, and it felt like as if it was barbed wires on my chest, my back, which they kicked so much, and my legs, as I'll show you everything on my body. the sides of my tummy, they put those things which felt like barbed wires. They were inflicting more pain. They told me that Zake, you should know that colleagues, I want to tell you that in that room, they never talked about distribution of food at all. I was never beaten for distributing food because it was not talked about anywhere within even that room. It was never done. Threats to me in my whole life. I've never experienced tribal statements like which I felt in that room. And most of the words, 90%, it was in Lunyankole, and a few words were said, like 10% in Luganda, and they were mocking me. Even reminded me one time, a few weeks before we lost Rita Nam Kenya and Dani Cheyune, that is like we had you crying out to the Katikkiro to tell the Kabaka to say a word about the killings happening on Ugandans, that so that they can stop at least within Uganda and other areas. So, where is your Kabaka here to help you? Where is your Katikkiro to help you? You people, this country doesn't belong to you, and you should know that. It is high time you quit politics. But spent on other things. One man came and stepped so hard on my head. And he told me in Luganda to repeat after him. As he was beginning to tell me those words which I should repeat after him. Hesitating, that cold more kicks on my lower back, he said, which still hurts up to now. I want to assure you that I was only fighting for my life. I had to say everything without telling me. Zake, Nangamugamba Zake, Okufanulu Adelo, Tikwagala Kudamukulava. Ngowakanya, President, His Excellency, the President of Uganda, Yoweri Kaguta Museveni, the Honorable, they told me never to also talk about and oppose the First Lady, Janet Kataha Museveni, and also their most honorable son, Kanelugaba, the next president, and those are the words they were telling me to repeat after. Zake, okuva n'olwaleero, toddangamu kubanga owakanya. President w'eggwanga lino, Yoweri Kaguta Museveni, Janet Kataha Museveni, wamu no HT when you kind of Lugaba Muhozi President Adako, never began Gamba and you get it. Never Gamba Zake, and to Damu to Kulidango, Gambanga, Wari, Mantibo, Honorable Chabulan, President Adako. Who can not see what Olamu and say, Kubanga Chinochitanika would handy to Genda Kukula Gako, teacher to Solo Kukola, Kubanga Mwe. Abaganda, temuli sobola wadde okufuga keberu jyoni ndala yona. I want to tell you this. has been my fourth time when I'm being tortured. This is my fourth time as a member of parliament being tortured. The first time I'd just come to parliament during the 24th coup, where I was tortured, you remember very well, where my head was hit. The second time, I remember all those times, actually I don't need to repeat all of them, even the one where they tear gassed my house in Michiana, still by the same DPC Alex Mwene, participated a lot in my beating. Still, from there, they called Honorable Kyagulanyi still, also a dog. And one of them was mimicking him while speaking in some kind of mocking way. No one will be demonstrating for you because we are running the show. People under lockdown. We are the only ones running the show. No one will demonstrate for you. You'll be here and no one will come for your help. I felt so bad. All that happening, friends, these people got out of that building, and I remember one person ran to me and I heard the voice saying, Zake tokaba nyomunange, bino bye tuyitamu bulijjo, Zake do not cry, this is what we experience every day here, because they had dropped me now in another place which felt like a cell. Zake tokaba, bino bye tuyitamu bulijjo. N'abalala ne batandika okuba nga bajja gye ndi, ne bagamba Zake, this place is called Semwai, and the torture is done from the basement. They informed me and they cried to me that Zake, for you a leader, I think you'll not be kept here for so long like us. For us, we've stayed here. Some of them, they're telling me they were there for months, so many months, and others for years. Well, at that same way, torture center. They really requested me that I should really help them when I'm released, that I really expose whatever is happening in that place, that at least they be released, or at least they face the court and that serve in prison, even when they committed certain crimes. That took around something like 20 minutes or 30, these people came back. They came back, they handcuffed me, they removed the handcuffs from my hands, and now they put them outside, they put them behind my back, and that is the so-called Kandoya. They dragged me out. They put me back to the patrol. But this time, I was facing down. I was facing down, not like the other time when I was coming from Etiana. Well, I was facing up. This time I was facing down since that put my, they handcuffed me from behind. They still suspended me in air, like how they did it from Etiana. All that happening, they drove for some few minutes and they reached some other place. They still untied me, got me off the truck, they dragged me, still with beatings and everything. Beating was just happening all the time. All the kind of beating you can think of, to summarize everything, because now I'm getting tired. They put me under the floor, which was, I felt, cemented, but they poured a certain chemical on me, which was very cold on my hands, all over the body. It made me feel so much pain, so much pain. It was very cold, and I don't know if it was made for what purpose, but as I would try to turn around, I would feel that I was under a table on a cemented ground. I shouted from there, I groaned in pain. They told me, do not shout. This is not your father's premises. Instead of concentrating to your father's business, who has become rich under this regime, you wouldn't be the person to actually oppose Mr. Museveni. They told me so many insults, friends. I can't remember. I really can remember everything, but I'm getting so tired to tell you each and everything they said, but so many insults and tribal statements. And I want to put it clear that in my whole life, I want to put it on record, I have been one of the people who have been actually talking against tribalism and any kind of sectarianism. And I remember also the Honorable Chagulani, as our leader institutionally, within our ranks, he has always been against that. In the morning, within that other second place, they made me join. They put me in a cell where I joined other captives, and they're the ones who lifted me. And that was the second day. I was inside that place. They told me that that place is the one called the SIU torture chambers. Bachita Echiyumba Bo Mundomu. The Arab was so friendly to me and other captives within. I found out there were so many journalists within that place. And I want to categorically talk about one person of the Voice of Africa called Katende. Yeah, he was so friendly to me, because they looked after me, saying that I was unable to sit, I was unable to stand, and all that. They would be lifting me, they would be bringing me stuff where I can urinate from. They told me that those people have 1 meal a day of Persian beans, and in the morning they would be given porridge. Since I was so sullen, with blood all over me, all over my mouth, this person they called Arabi within that place could keep for me a cup of porridge, which I would take in the evening when it is cold, and that's what I would feed on the whole day. But they told me, the captives within, that there is what they call interrogation. An interrogation includes insults, beating, and you'd be put in a separate room. You slashed, you're given a lot of strokes. They told them all that. I felt so bad, because I told them what about it. Those captives also told me that many of them were also taken to that semi basement where they were also tortured from. I remember one OC in that place, whom they called OC, the captives. He's by the names Walugembe They call him Musa. I remember she used to hand me over to a man he called to SJ.